Hello again, Izzy at Digital Goja Showrooms. Here's a question placed by intermediate users about the Nikon D500. If this video helps you out, remember to hit us up with a like button underneath, and as always, subscribe to our channel for future unboxing sessions and frequently asked questions just like this, and also to share with fellow photographers. And don't forget, when in Miami, visit Digital Goja Showrooms. Does it have a touchscreen? Yes, but it's not the conventional design for a touchscreen. Basically, what Nikon did is you can use a touchscreen for a playback situation. So let's show right now. Let's have a picture on here. Hopefully I have, so you can do this. Notice how I can move around and zoom back and forth and take a look at any kind of detail that I want on the picture. Or if I have the camera on live view, I can go ahead and either have it as the shutter or I can touch focus. So notice how I can actually pinpoint where I want the focus to be. But that's it. You don't have access to change menu or any of that sort of stuff. So basically, again, they gave you the features that a lot of us tend to use, which is especially the touch focus, and if you choose to also depress the shutter right from the actual screen, like I'm doing here. And then, of course, on your playback mode, being able to zoom and pinch and also flick back and forth between images. So that's basically what it's allowing us to do. Oh, and don't forget, it is a swivel. You can angle it for macro shots or overhead shots. So that's a nice feature also.